The Las Vegas Raiders really hit with Quinton Jefferson. I think he's going to be a fantastic player for the Raiders, not only because he's a good pass rusher, but he does a lot of really good things, especially when it comes to utilizing his hands, utilizing a couple of different moves to be able to pressure the quarterback. Now, here's the thing. He's not Aaron Donald, right? He's not Quinton Williams. He's not going to get 15 sacks in any season. But what he does is he's going to push the pocket in, right? He's going to bring a little bit of pressure through the middle. We don't have to rely on Max Crosby and Cleveland Farrell to provide all the pressure anymore, right? We can get pressure from the inside, and Quinton Jefferson does a great job in this specific play. As you see him here, he's going to just give this center a left hand, right arm over, and that is a fantastic move to be able to be a very good center, right? That's a fantastic move right there. And I think this is going to give the Raiders another piece. It's going to give the Raiders another player. We will have a ton of depth this season. What I want to do in this video, for the rest of this video, is just kind of discuss some of the plays and just get into Quinton Jefferson's film, man. Let's just jump right into it. All right, guys, you're going to see Quinton Jefferson right here lined up between the guard, the right guard and right tackle. He does a fantastic job basically utilizing a similar move to the last one. Obviously, this is a run play. He's going to basically give this tackle the left right arm over, and he's going to stop the fullback here short. Now, in my personal opinion, I think the best part of Quinton Jefferson's game, without a doubt, is going to be his run defense, right? I think he's a fantastic run defender, and he's going to come in and he's going to help the Raiders be a top tier run defense. You know, I just have a gut feeling that this Raiders defense is going to end up being a top 10 defense in run defense. You know, overall, we'll see, right? That's going to depend on the players. But Gus Bradley's scheme is all about stopping the run, right? He'll put that eighth guy in the box. Even if you're in, you know, a spread offense, he does not care. He's not going to let you run the ball. And I think Quinton Jefferson was brought in for that reason, man. You see plays like this where he's able to just beat the tackle, and I think that's Mike McGlinchey, who's, you know, pretty good tackle. Great job right there. Gets in there and stops the fullback. With that being said, let's jump into the next play. I want you guys to watch this play. Quinton Jefferson's lined up between the right guard and right tackle. You know, this is a fantastic play from the defense in general. And I want you guys to really watch, like, this defensive end, this defensive tackle, and just kind of watch how, like, every single player basically fills a gap. And this is how you play the run, right? If every single person can fill their gap and basically fill their responsibility, you're going to stop any run play no matter what the play is. And, I mean, just look at that. There's nowhere, absolutely nowhere for this running back to go, right? And this is just a loss of 1 yard. But the important part of this play is the fact that Quinton Jefferson fills this gap, right? If you're a defensive tackle, I'm going to just use an example like Maurice Hurst, right? Let's say Maurice Hurst is Quinton Jefferson in this play. And let's just say for some odd reason, Maurice Hurst can't get into this gap, and instead he gets turned around, right? And let me clarify exactly what I mean by that. At the point of attack, the right guard and right tackle double, right? Right there. You see that double team? They double team the defensive tackle. But Quinton Jefferson holds his ground, right? And let me back this up and kind of get into it a little bit deeper. So because Quinton Jefferson holds his ground and doesn't get turned, there's no gap. There's nowhere for the running back to go. The defensive end does a great job crashing down, gets his arm on the right tackle, and really just shuts it down from the outside. There's, again, nowhere for the running back to go. Quinton Jefferson is going to give the Raiders a player that knows how to play within his responsibilities. It's going to give the Raiders a player who knows what to do in certain situations. Run fits is the biggest part of playing defense from a defensive perspective, right? As far as the defensive player's perspective. Every player here fills their gap perfectly. It does not get better than this, man. Like, this is beautiful right here. So huge shout out to the Buffalo Bills defensive coordinator, because this is fantastic. Now, of course, you got to give a shout out to the players as well. Quinton Jefferson was one of the players, right? One of the five or six players that was in on this play. But run fits is huge. Quinton Jefferson's going to bring that for the Raiders. So let's get moving forward and just get into the next play. I guess watch Quinton Jefferson right here and watch him just control this offensive lineman. This is beautiful, right? Now he's playing the one tech, which means he could be doubled. He really isn't doubled that well, but he just controls this center, man. And here's the thing, right? Technically, the center actually does a good job getting around him, right? But the thing is the center gets pushed back, right? And that's the thing. If you're going to try to hook the one tech like this, you can't let him push you back that far, right? Because he's just resetting the line of scrimmage. There's nowhere for the running back to go, right? Now, if the running back is able to basically get around Quinton Jefferson here, and I'm going to pause it for you guys in just a second. If the running back is able to get into this gap, basically, he's done a good job, right? Like that center. But the thing is Quinton Jefferson's so strong, he pushes the center back. And the center has no way he's going to be able to win. And Jefferson blows this play up. You'll see it a little bit better from the backside. Kind of how Quinton Jefferson here pushes this back, right? I mean, like, look at where the center ends up, all right? He ends up much further back than you'd ideally want. You know, and again, that's a great job by Jefferson to hit the center at the point of attack, get low, get his helmet, his arms, get into those shoulder pads, and just drive the center backwards. Great job. He's going to bring that to the Raiders, and this kind of stuff pumps me up, man. Let's move forward and let's get into the next play. Now, here's Quinton Jefferson playing the inside shade of that right guard. Here's the thing, right? When you're going to double team Quinton Jefferson, you better freaking bring it, because just like Jonathan Hankins, who in my opinion is a top five run defender, I think Quinton Jefferson might be right there as well. Like, the guy's good against the run, and I think the Raiders defense is going to be really stout against the run this year. It's going to come down to how the linebackers play, right? Do they step up or do they continue to not be as good? But here's the play. You're going to see Quinton Jefferson basically take that double team on, right? Like, they're trying to seal him off, and he does not allow that center to be able to get around him, and of course he makes the play. Think about this for a second. When you're a right guard and you're a center and you have Quinton Jefferson, and you guys know that sometimes a double team doesn't even work, that's tough. And then you think about the fact that on the other end, you might have a player like Jonathan Hankins, who, you know, a lot of people might not know this, but Jonathan Hankins is a stud against the run. And a lot of people might not think about that because he's not, you know, a 5-6-7 sack defensive tackle, but playing the run and playing the pass are two different parts of your game. Quinton Jefferson's great against the run. He also does a good job pushing the pocket back, right? He's good at being able to push players. Jonathan Hankins isn't as good as being able to push players back, but Jonathan Hankins is still kind of young, right? I think he'll get a little bit better as his career kind of progresses. I'm excited, man. I'm very, very excited to see a Quinton Jefferson play. I think he's going to be a fantastic player for the Raiders. He's a big, lengthy defensive tackle. I think he's like 6'4", 6'5". So he's a big guy, man. Let's move forward and get into the next play. Now, going back a couple of years, Quinton Jefferson, back when he was with the Seattle Seahawks, here he is. He's kind of playing, obviously, his goal line pack. He's kind of playing the defensive end spot. He's fast too, man. Don't think that just because he's so big that he's not fast. The guy's fast, man. This play is a great example. He's going to be able to go all the way around the tight end and still make the play. And this play is just a run right through the middle, right? I mean, look at that. He gets right over that tight end. He's been doing that throughout his career, as we've seen in the last couple of plays. That's a great freaking play, man. Look at how he just swims right over the tight end. And that's expected, right? People think that he's so big that he's probably not going to swim over you. He's most likely going to use some sort of power move, but he'll go over you, man. And he has good hands. So I'm excited to kind of see how that's going to benefit the Raiders, right? How he utilizes his hands. I think it's going to definitely make a big difference. I think he's going to be one of those guys that he might end up with 3 sacks this season, or 4 sacks, or 5 sacks. But he'll have a ton of plays where he stops the run for a loss of 1 or 2 yards. He'll have plays where maybe it's a gain of absolutely nothing or a gain of 1 yard. He'll have a lot of positive, impactful plays against the run for the Raiders. Overall, I'm really pumped up, man. I want to show you guys a couple more plays with Quinton Jefferson. I think it's very important for you guys to like get the full picture of kind of some of the things he does and some of the things he's done in the past. I think another part of Quinton Jefferson's game to point out is the fact that he doesn't give up, right? Here's a play where he's going to get double teamed. The slide is going to go his way. Let me just speed this up a little bit. As you see here, he's about to get double teamed right there. But I like the fact that, like, look at the initial punch, right? Like, he gets aggressive and he pushes 73. And 73 is a good freaking guard, right? He pushes him back and he's going to end up with a sack on this play because he doesn't give up. He fights through it. Even the running back gets involved a little bit, or maybe the running back trips and hurts himself. But I love the fight. I love the effort. And, you know, if he brings this to the Raiders, if he brings that effort, he brings that fight to the Raiders, he's going to be a good player for us. You know, he's not, again, going to get a ton of sacks, but what he is going to do is he is going to be able to be a rotational player, right? I mean, he'll probably end up getting the first few snaps of the game, and then someone like Mo Hurst will probably rotate in, maybe with, like, Hankins, and then he jumps to the one. At the same time, I can also see him coming out, and then maybe like Cleveland Farrell jumps in with Mo Hurst, and then you have Crosby and Yannick on the outsides. But you know, I'm pumped up, man. I think this is gonna be a great fit for the Raiders overall. It makes sense, right? You bring in players that have proven themselves, right? They have the production, right? It's not all about just like the potential, because the Raiders have a lot of guys with potential, man. At a certain point, you need to get guys that have proven production. And Quinton Jefferson has that, and I'm pumped up that he's going to be a Raider. Let me know what you guys think. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you did, make sure to smash that thumbs up button and smash that subscribe button. And I will see you guys next time with another video.